Welcome back, everybody, here to your last match of the night. Quantic going up against Flipsid3 here for the RaidCall EMS One Summer Group Stage. It is Group Stage A, and we are wanting to know who will be that team that will be the first team out of all the group stages to qualify themselves for the LAN final in Poland. The winner of this game will take it out, and, well, the winner of this game is definitely going to be wide open right now. When you check out your draft, luckily the man who can laugh at it with me is my co-commentator, Capitalist. Welcome back.
Speaking of laughing, what happened there with your intro there, Toby? For a second there, like, there was some silence, and I thought I was, like, waiting for the intro. And then when you did finally do your intro, it was like I thought I was listening to NPR. You're like, hello, everybody.
Something.
Welcome to the cast.
Something died, man. Something died. So I
decided, it's always something.
Yeah. There's always something that goes wrong. Always something that goes wrong.
Well, you know what might go wrong this game?
Flipsid3 with CK?
Has Wisp, yes, indeed.
And Quantic are like, yeah, we got this. We can beat a Wisp. We just go Gyro, we go Batrider. They got Flying Vision, they got Jump-Ins, they got Jump-Outs, they got Team Fight possibilities. And then Flipsid3, yeah, but you got CK Wisp. What you gonna do?
This is like the ultimate Game 3, right? So Quantic dominated with CK Wisp, and then we had Game 2 where they seemed to just, I don't know, give up early. Due to Flipsid3, Flipsid3 was playing really, really well. That's not to discount. I think Quantic was still definitely in the game. It's just that Flipsid3 was taking control of it. There's no doubt about that.
Mm-hmm.
Flipsid3 did play very, very well. That being said, Game 3, Quantic's just like, here, go ahead. You play your little with CK. We'll show you how to counter it, my friend. We'll show you how to counter it.
Well, either that or they're going to get destroyed by it and then find themselves in the lower part of the bracket. Either way we look at it, it's going to be an interesting evening, no matter how we look at this one. So Quantic, they're going to ban out the Keeper of the Light, because that's what they used before, so no mirror drafts coming out in this one. Keeper of the Light, he will be taken out in this scenario, and this means that Quantic just want to stick it to him. They're going to attempt to run the crazy tri-lane. Clockwork's going to be one of the first ones actually banned out, interestingly enough, because I'm not feeling that from Quantic. I'm actually feeling Gyro on the bottom lane combining up with someone like a Lina as well as a Bane or something else along those kind of lines. I'm not feeling this. If SD's still in the pool too, I wouldn't be surprised if he's a selection, but then they'll have to go with someone else like a Chikiro. Yeah, and Chen as well. They're worried about it. There's the Bane taken out by Mania. No way he's going to risk that one. But I would not be surprised if we see SD, if we see Jakiro, if we see maybe some other kind of like aggressive style supports on the bottom lane just to give her a shot. Either that or Batrider does go the solo mid. Jaro can stay top lane, and they can take a different style of aggression towards that bottom lane. And we at least get the Darkseer, so either way, the Batrider would be mid. Darkseer or Jaro, which lane? Question mark could still be there. I don't think they're gonna do the aggressive tri lane now. As I see that Darkseer, I don't mm-hmm. I don't feel it, man. I don't feel it.
Yeah, I agree. I like the ban coming out from Flipsid3 taking away that clockwork, but they take away one of those really good utility offlaners that would be able to respond well to the with CK ganks, being able to just basically jump in with that ultimate, but even just the cogs, extremely disruptive versus some of those ganks. So I like that ban. Unfortunately, though, the other utility offlaner who is going to be just as good, if not better, being able to see that with CK teleport in and lay down the wall vacuum, followed up with some extra AoE disables after that, that Darkseer. He's also going to be very strong versus this. So, Flipsid3 is instead choosing to ban out the Bane instead of the Darkseer. I'm not sure if I entirely agree with that, but it is very, very good versus Chaos Knight Wisp as well. So,
I agree with it, man. It's just fucking mad. You're going to take it out because of him.
Yeah.
There's no other. If there was no other reason, that reason would still be enough. The question I have for Mania right now is, what is he looking to combine up with? Is he looking to pick up like that combination hero with the CK like right now? Or is he considering other lanes? Was going to be my word. So he goes for Puck. Puck for that middle lane. Which means they're still missing an offlaner. And they're still missing a secondary support. And Quantic, they're missing both their supports. Unless Gyro is a gang and he plays support by Goblack. Which I wouldn't put it past him, really. But at the same time, up against the CK as well as Wisp, you want to have more control. They're going to go with, yeah, give me my aggression! Undying comes up. This is nice. And if they go with their normal combination, it'll be a support Rubick. It'll be a support Rubick with the Undying. They can run it with just the Darkseer on the bottom lane too. Let Jaro do his solo top. Let Batrider do his solo mid. At this point, Flipsid3 aren't going to have anything that's going to stop those two guys from finding their farm.
Yeah. Something Flipsid3 does have potentially on their side, even though they did pick up the puck, and it would be very... yeah, the lanes actually wouldn't pan out. I was going to say they could do... they still have dual lanes open to them, right? CK Wisp is a classic dual lane middle where you pick up an early bottle on CK, give it to Wisp. You have rune control. You have constant spam ability with that bottle just to be able to constantly try and go for that kill on whoever's middle. And that would be a good way to deal with the aggressive trend lane that Quantic's going to be running, especially since I've said time and time again, Undying is a very strong aggressive trend lane hero, especially versus Wisp and CK. So I really like that pickup, but unfortunately they kind of locked themselves into a tri lane with this puck pickup because they can't run him. If they did do dual lanes, right, dual lane of CK Wisp middle, another dual lane at bottom, and then the puck solo at top, he'd be going up against a gyrocopter, and the gyrocopter does well versus puck in middle. It's even worse if gyrocopter is allowed to be in a safe lane against puck. So They're going to have to run something different. They're going to throw Weaver here against the gyrocopter. I think this is a strong pickup by them, but I kind of worried that Gyrocopter, I wonder if Gyrocopter is actually able to win that lane 1v1 if he's given counters by his supports.
If he's given a sentry ward or something like that, then yeah. But yeah. Either way you look at it, like, even if he doesn't win the early portion of that lane, the Undying plus whoever can rotate very quickly up to that Weaver. And that's why I kind of feel like it's got to be a Rubick as their last one. It's got to be a Telekinesis. It's got to be pick up and hold. Someone that can keep that Weaver in position. Either that or... oh, I just thought of Silencer or Skywrath to add them into the mix with this as well. Wouldn't be bad options. There's a Rubick ban from Mania. But to add an option up against the Puck and the Weaver, you need someone with a Silence. And at this point, Quantic didn't have a single hero in their lineup that would want to go an Orchid or a Scythe. The Darkseer would love it, but it's a very luxurious item for him. To have some kind of ability like a Global Silence from Silencer, that kind of thing would lock down the CK as well as the Wisp for their movements, Puck, Weaver. I'm really feeling the Silencer. I'm really, really feeling it. But I don't know if Quantic or Godblack is feeling the same thing.
Yeah, I think Silencer... I think you're on the right track there, that Silencer would be a very strong pickup for them. I just don't think that he... if they're going to go for an aggressive tri-lane, I think I'd rather see Skywrath Mage just because of the initiation. But instead, they're going to go for that very, very hard counter to the CK Wiz combo, which is the Naga Siren ultimate.
Yeah, put him to sleep, which means BKBs have to be up for CK as well as Weaver very quickly, but this now turned it into a gyro support. It could be a Naga support, but I highly doubt it. Soshka prefers to run his Naga, which means Undying and Gyro are going to be looking to come in close. They get the Ensnare, they get the Decay, they get the full Rocket Barrage off on a hero, and they shut down that hero straight away. That's the plan, Stan. That's the plan. Or do we actually say... it's still going to be Gyro, Undying, and Darkseer in the bottom lane. No, they don't have a controller. They need to have the net. They need to have the net from Naga. Either that, or they are just running a safe lane. No, they've got to stick it to the CK. They've got to stick it to the CK. Unless we throw Batrider in the bottom lane. No, they still need a controller. Crystal Bane is the last one by Flipsid3. So there's nice Nova, Frostbite, all these wonderful things put together. It's actually Man on the Naga. Goblack support, Sign on the Gyro. So it's going to be a core Gyro, a core Darkseer, and a core Batrider. Funzie in the middle lane, and they're going to try and run an aggressive tri lane with the Naga support and Undying with it.
Yeah. This is, I actually think this is a really good pickup for a couple of reasons. Like, you take Rubick out of the pool, that was probably their preferable pickup, but you still have got a single target disable, long-term disable that's going to work well with Undying, with that ensnare. And then on top of that, there aren't really a whole lot of big spells for him to steal. Shikuchi is extremely strong on Rubick, but still, instead they go for, instead of being able to have that spell steal, they have another really good counter to the CK Wisp jump in, which is that Song of Sirens. So that's really all they need from her is lockdown, and then the additional disable going up against the CK Wisp combo with that ultimate is just icing on the cake right there. So I think this is a really good idea by them. Naga Siren, we've seen her being run support a little bit more often. Sometimes we'll see her like soul mid and those sort of situations. But it's still going to be like all of the right things are there, right? She still does, it's almost like a Tide, right? Being able to have a lockdown with ensnare and then also being able to hit a nice nuke that does some minus armor where Gyrocopter is really going to benefit from. It's the same actually in Dying Will as well. I think it's a strong pickup. The question is whether or not they're going to be good enough to be able to do well in this aggressive tri lane. Because they normally, when you see aggressive tri lanes, a lot of times lately you've been seeing a harder carry, at least some sort of semi carry in the off lane. Here we have Darkseer, who is a great team fight hero, great utility, being able to pick up early mech and those sort of things adds great to team fight. But if Gyrocopter, if they don't win their tri lane hero, they're going to be lacking in damage severely. If Gyrocopter gets shut down in this aggressive tri lane, these things don't go well, they get overly aggressive, they get picked off, whatever, Quantic's really going to be feeling it in the mid game.
Oh, yeah. Most definitely, man. Most definitely. Oh, I like this move. Miguel is actually going to be going middle lane, but Mania as well as Ryze are instantly heading towards the top. They're going to go up against the Darkseer up there. Puts Weaver and Crystal Maiden on the bottom. Funzi into the middle lane, and Undying's already going to say hello at the very, very start. And now Naga and Silent on the bottom lane, they're going to realize what's down here, and the pings will come, and instantly say, wait, we have a Weaver down here. Question mark, do we stay with this? Is it still worth it?
Yeah, this is interesting, but I still feel that if they just rotate the Undying top, they should actually be fine. Just the early Ion Shell damage mixed in with the harassment from Decay, it's actually going to be pretty powerful versus CK, who is relying on his initial amount of strength to be able to survive and get last hits and deal with the harassment of Ion Shell. But you start taking away some of that strength with Decay, and he's really going to be feeling those Ion Shell hits. So this is still going to be decent for Quantic, even though I think Flipsid did make the right move dodging this tri lane.
They mix it up, and actually takes away a lot of the risk for both the teams. Like, Sion and Bucking Man, they're going to do their best to find their CS down here, and it's going to be rather difficult, but it's not too shabby. Miracle will start in his pull, and we're already seeing Goldblack has already started up on here. So we've managed to pull down to a couple of Centaurs, and now Ryze and CK definitely going to know what's going on. There's a hero missing from bottom lane, but dual lanes are so, like, the risk factor is just so much lower on dual lanes. Whoop, Centaur is about to get sniped. There's already first decay, and it was sniped out by the CK, but he is still, however, down to 549 health, and Wisp is not looking too healthy either. Decay will come off cooldown, and nice little move there by Goldblack. Takes the aggro to the side, and now we got another double set of decay. This Wisp is not healthy if he wants to come back into this all, but they want to contest up the status. I think Mania realizes he can't really do that.
Yeah. This is just kind of turned from what was originally looking at some potential kills versus Wisp is now just controlling them. Really keeping the CK, even though they're going to get the full amount of experience and they won't be able to shut down Wisp down in that regard, they will be able to keep CK as weak as possible by denying him a lot of this CS. Goblak with those really, really smart pull there, and then just being able to be so aggressive. Naga Siren bottom. Invis, they're looking to see if they... Oh, here's the option. Shikuchi's down.
Yep, that's what they're waiting for. But at the same time, Bucking Mad, no. There's not enough follow-up. Silent ran up, and then goes into the Rocket Barrage on the Creep Wave. But when they've got a Crystal Maiden there, getting a kill on that bottom lane is next to impossible. She'll Nova and slow you up so you can't get close enough to get a proper Rocket Barrage off. And if that doesn't work, she's also got the lock-in stun. So the Frostbite that will be there. And then that turns around to you taking way too much damage and have to fall back.
Yeah. It's going to be tough, but I still think the option that was there with the Rocket Barrage, just being able to throw down the counter ward, get a couple auto attacks off, and then snare, making sure the second Shikuchi wouldn't go anywhere. But still, playing defensive is probably smarter for Quantic at this point anyway. They're doing well in their top lane, shutting down the CK. He's down to 12 CS, which is really unfortunate.
Rise, Courier, how fast is this reflex time? And he doesn't have enough damage to kill off the Courier anyway. But it will bring in the Soul Ring. So Soshka's now got that little sucker. And they send the Courier up north. Got to keep it away from Ryze. He's getting his timing right. He's stopping Goldblight from pulling that camp over to the side. How's that middle lane looking? 19 for 6 up against an 8 for 3. Actually, Funzy. Didn't realize how strong he is. Wonder if we get this Blink Dagger at the right time, though. Forever 1400.
Yeah, apparently. You know, he's off to a good start, and there's no surprise versus a Puck. Unfortunately, he kind of needed that rune. Good snipe off by the Wisp. That's really going to help out Miguel, because now he has to wait for the next Bottle Crow before he can really, again, keep Miguel out of experience and out of gold range.
Mm-hmm. Man, this is one of those lanes that, like, one of those games where all three lanes could just erupt at any point. But yeah. It's going to take time. It's going to take time. Like, this moment, Goldblack, again, he finds himself getting stunned up by a Centaur, but he turns around and gets a double decay. Then on bottom lane, Unicorn are racing down Sana Mad. And Mad wants to turn around and get a Riptide off on Unicorn. So it's just this to and fro, tip for tap. I poke you with a stick, you throw a stone at me kind of thing.
And even middle, now that Funzy's about to have the mana with this incoming bottle.
You're thinking about Lasso?
I mean, he doesn't even necessarily have to Lasso. He honestly, if he gets the right Sticky Napalm at the right time, you know, obviously Lasso is going to be the best versus when Miguel tries to escape with the orb and then throw it on Lasso, but he can honestly just harass him down and kick him out of lane pretty easily.
Well, he's been trying to do that for a while now. He's been rather successful, but Puck, also with stick charges, able to push it back out, get a little bit more. CK now with full strength treads. I think they're looking to go on Soshka. Run around the side, he's got his Iron Chill up and running, but he's going to need some help. Undying's already rotating down a Mania. She takes a lot of damage, and that level one back is just so big. Failing. So CK was able to retreat.
So they picked up an early bottle on Wisp. So they're going to try and abuse the tether regen as much as possible, which they're doing all right. CK has actually picked up his
rotation
CS
top
a little bit more.
And Ryze and Mania. They don't have the vision of this. Funzy now with a haste rune. Lasso, there she goes. Off on Mania. Oh, come on! Come on! 4 seconds to over on Soshka. Mania's on the run back out of here. And now Miguel throws his ulti down. And it'll be Soshka running over there. She chased down Miguel. The damage almost enough to kill off the CK, but not going to be enough. And Gyro dies in the bottom lane.
So they had the engagement. Basically, Gyrocopter was able to pick off the Crystal Maiden, but Weaver was able to trade for the Gyrocopter. So worth the first blood in that regards, but they still took down the carry. So
just saying right now, I hate you both. Quantic and Flipsid3. Funzy now on the retreat in mid. Reality Rift going to pull him back in again. 2 seconds on that stun. That one we get to see. But seriously, middle lane and top lane connect together, and that's not where the first blood is. It's down the bottom lane. All right.
Nothing. Don't be too bitter. Don't be too bitter, Toby. At least there was no pull, right? There's no pull.
Yes, as long as there's no pull, missing first blood doesn't count. However, Silent, here we go on bottom lane. That's a lot of damage from the flag cannon into the Rocket Barrage, and Unicorn dropping low on life. He has level 6, but no mana to actually use the damn thing. And now Batrider dies in the middle lane. CK as well as Puck. This is now the new dual lane in mid. Even requiring the Puck ulti to get that kill, making it 3-2.
Yeah, Wisp is going to be getting some solo experience at top. He's level 5, just hit level 5, so he's still a little ways away from 6. So giving him the solo lane is actually a really good idea, especially since CK is already level 7.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they only need basically a 4-3 combo as a minimum on that CK to start ganking around with the Wisp ultimate. But having level 9, so the 4-4 plus 1 are critical. That's what you want to have, ideally, before you start ganking around. But when you're 8 minutes 30 into the game, you're not going to complain about having a 4-4 combo. Especially when now he's got a wand, he's got a bracer up and running. So I'm going to have to buy him a TP scroll, but apart from that, he's good. And Miguel's looking for an opening in mid. Invis rune, searching for Funzie, but Funzie just gives up on it. It looks like he's looking to stack up the camp. Yep. Flame break to pop him. And Miguel's going to block the pull. Frustrating there. Funzie did everything right. The only thing he doesn't know is the fact that Miguel is currently... It's like, hey, hang on. Something's not right here. Especially when support's coming in. CK's on his way up. There's no ward for the dire side looking for this, but they're still going to throw the puck oldie down. And Funzie, stunned up once, rift back in again. 3 seconds on the Chaos Bolt. Undying drops the two, so Plus gets a good decay off. Miguel losing a lot of life from this one. Vax him back in again. And now, Soul Rip. Oh, attempted. But they still pick off the puck. Two for the price of one. Crystal Maiden going down the bottom lane. Looks like Nagarold is able to get both Sound as well as Bucky Matt away from that one.
Yeah, they just, there's nothing Weaver can do. Like, Weaver is really good at mobility and keeping her own hero alive, but when she's coupled with support and they jump that support, there's nothing he can really do. He does good damage over time, but by the time that damage is actually becoming relevant, the other hero is already dead and it's 2v1.
Well, Funzie, are you next? I feel he's next. Yeah. Tether, Rift, stun, 3 seconds on it, and then a couple spirits to come in close, and that's Funzie's death thought. Yeah, it is. Even with that flame break to bump him back out again, not going to work, especially when you get help from Miguel. He's already up here on the top lane and mad teeping himself in, but they know he doesn't have ultimate, and they can see him on the lane. It's just like, yeah? Go. Miguel has ulti in 7 seconds, and maybe that's what they're waiting for. They're going to rotate down. They're looking for another jungler. Tether's got to happen right now, because they're going to find Soshka, and they know he's going to surge away. There's a surge, rift back in again, and then Tether's done. 2 seconds on the Chaos Bolt as well, and they get the kill. And again, Goldblight tries to drop the Tombstone, pop the Decay, and Ryze. We've actually got an ulti back to base, but this is a dangerous thing to do. Silence ulti is going to wear off, and Miracle... He's not making his way up here. The question is, who's whispering back? It's just himself. He'll see if he can tether out to something. But he can't get close enough to anything. He'll go down.
That was smart. Just knowing that Quantic was going to be able to group up on that one, not wanting to bring the CK back. Just sacrificing for that kill. Nicely done. Bucky Matt actually in a little bit of trouble on top, taking a bit of harassment damage there from Miguel. But Miguel, he really needs to start working on his Blink Dagger. Unfortunately, the early lane shut down where he just wasn't able to pick up any CS. I mean, he has 31 CS and it's 11 minutes in. It goes to show how well he was shut down in that middle lane. So they need to be able to get some more ganks off of the CK Wisp and take some towers like they just did. That way they can get Puck back into this game.
And Unicorn, he's having a great old time. You want to take towers, he's doing a good job on the bot. Especially keeping this catapult alive for as long as possible. What are we actually looking overall for advantage? Surprisingly, there's nothing in it for gold. The advantage is only like maybe 100, 150 gold. And that's going the way of the Radiant side. That's one tower apiece, so there's nothing in that. And then you look to the experience. 800 going the way of Flipside. Again, very little to nothing in that. For me, this whole game kind of feels like it's always been Flipside's action. Like, they've been walking around, they'll be the ones to get the better initiations off. But if I also look at the last hit and denies, I'm seeing 3 out of the top 4 being Quantic. I'm seeing Silent, I'm seeing the Batrider Funzie, and I'm seeing someone else dying. It's Sochka, who's actually number 1 as far as last hit denies. Vak, he can't get away from this one. Pops a quick salve, but he knows the second he walks in the spirits, he's dead. Naga was thinking about the ultimate. But the Wisp ulti was what initiated that gank, and they just jumped straight back into the middle lane. So it is already too late.
Yeah, I think one of the most important things is the fact that Gyrocopter has only died once, picked up 3 kills, has 51 CS. He's got a lot of CS on the board, and CK Wisp, they need to make him our priority sometime soon. It's fine if they let him farm up a little bit more, but once he has that BKB, he's kind of unstoppable. You can no longer teleport on him, so they need to take advantage of that now.
Undying. He was just looking to D-ward, and now Naga in snare will go. They'll get a revenge kill out right now, but at the same time, CK combining up with Wisp again, and they're able to find that kill on the Batrider inside the jungle. And Ryze just looking to make a jump in mid, and they're going to find Mad. Oh, he was in range for a Rift, but actually now I look at it. No, they still got mana for the combo.
Think they were afraid of getting caught out by the Naga Siren so close to a tier 2, where it'd be really easy for the rest of Quantic to be able to respond in time. After the Naga Siren, they could just get blown up pretty easily, and they don't have that escape mechanism of Wisp ulti yet.
Yeah. I gotta find something else, man. Soshko, he's having a lot better time for levels-wise. Hits level 11 now, so they got 2 points up in his ultimate. This is really going to change around the way these team fights work for Flipside. Initiating in on an easy kill or not. Wisp ulti, bottom lane. Silent, you can see him out way too far. They've also got an Observer Ward, knowing there's no extra support to come and help him. And this is what you have to deal with when you go up against a Wisp CK. You cannot walk out by yourself saying, yeah, I can farm up the bottom lane and then just fall back to my tier 2 tower. Life doesn't work that way when you're going up against a CK Wisp. You must be in a pair, if not a trio, if not a quad, if not a 5-man. And now, same thing happens again. Goblin, like, a little bit too far out. Naga will throw out the ultimate. Only way they can stop that. And you see, Gold Black going into ultimate form. He just wants a good decay off from the side, and it's going to happen too. Miracle, well, you see that TP being out, then your ultimate. Soshka led off the wall, and the support coming in. Funzy's on the way, but no blink daggers available, and CK, he's feeling pretty good, farms up a couple of the Undying. But that's going to be all she wrote, while Unicorn continues to free farm bottom lane.
That was a lot of ultimates down. I think that they're actually good with that trade, Crystal Maiden, for all those ultimates. That now means that the next Wisp teleport, which they didn't use for that gank, it's going to be up in 20 seconds. It's going to be a very, very easy kill. It'd be nice to be able to gank the Gyrocopter again. They aren't grouping up whatsoever, which is where their strength is supposed to be. With the Tombstone and then the Naga Siren ultimate being able to set up really good team fights. Maybe now that they have mech, maybe they'll try for it.
Mm-hmm. And give her a shot, man. I mean, Soshka's got to do his job. And Undying has to stay alive a little bit longer. Goldblack's been having a real rough time doing that. In the meantime, Ryze just keeps pulling. CK, he's getting farmed. Level 11 now up for him. BKB, a grand total of 1100 away from being completed too. Miguel, nice jump! Perfect ulti. Wisp coming in as well. Silent, he's going to let off his ultimate as well, but it's already Mania on a killing streak. And looking for more. Bugs to come down. Wisp, well, he can tether and pull someone out. Mania's going to need that tier 2 tower pretty harshly. And yep, he's able to tether it. Miracle. What, dude? Trying to vac. Soshka almost backed him back in again to the tower. He's on the run. Bucky Mad can't keep up with him. So two heroes lost for Quantic underneath the tier 2 tower in the mid.
Yeah, that was a well-executed gank, exactly what they needed. Just Wisp goes in, they pick up an extra kill off the top of Miguel, initiating for them. They go right back to top to keep on farming. That's going to be very fast. BKB on Chaos Knight. Meanwhile, Gyrocopter, because he went a casual Yasha, is going to be suffering a lot due to these ganks. And I can't say, like, Quantic is supposed to be really hard to be get picked off by a lot of Quantic. Like, a lot of them are set up well to be able to defend against those CK Wisp ganks if they have more than one hero grouped up together. Unfortunately, though, they just keep getting picked off. Finally, they're going to group up. Silent's going to go with the rest of his team. Soksha, with that mechanism, they have really good team fight here to be able to force a middle tower down.
I'll give her a shot, man, but it's definitely slow goings. In the meantime, Unicorn is attacking their tier 2 tower in the bottom lane, and the CK Wiz combo going in through the top. Funzy just wants an opening. Blink the lasso, and he found one. He found Miracle, dragging him through the tree line, back closer towards Quantic. Flamebreak making sure he gets all the way in, but Park, four men on the ultimate, but he didn't get anyone on the silence. So they just pop off the mech, any kind of that damage is gone. And this will now be a tier 1 tower. It's a great ultimate, but great oldies need a great follow-up. and that just was not there.
Yeah, Wisp had just picked up his mech. So not only did they really want their mech for this next team fight, but also Weaver being able to split push heavily, they just should have just given up that tier 1 tower. Fortunately, Crystal Maiden getting caught there, and now the Puck ultimate is down because of that. Quantic, they see an opening for going for a tier 2, but honestly, tier 2 is kind of tanky. It's a dangerous position to put yourself in against the CK Wisp combo, especially the Weaver being able to provide a lot of damage in chases.
Mm-hmm. Especially now they need it. They kind of need it. They need a trade-off. They didn't defend their tier 2 tower on bottom lane. There's still CK, who actually ran straight past them before they came in. And then up to the top lane to farm up and push it out. He just got his BKB from that time he spent in the top lane. Small amount, as I said, he was before very, very close to having the recipe for BKB. But now it's here. A BKB CK with Wisp at level 11. This is a dangerous, dangerous world. And Quantic... dangerous worlds mean immortal items. In for Roshan time. And Goblet, is he really going to be the man that has to tank this up? I don't think he's going to be too happy that he has to do this. But there's no one else. Gyro doesn't have his lifesteal. Silence not involved. In fact, Silence, I think, just said no. Busy farming. Not going to do it. Now Soshka caught out. Blink, Silence. Can't run himself away. Puck throws the ulti. This time he's going to pick up Goblet 2. Wisp ulti. Going to bring him in. And there's CK. They go the Undying. But Naga throws his ulti out. Buys him some time. Soul Ripper's up. The Undead are also raising too. This back wall not really going to work. And 1 second time. And Ryze actually takes him back. But he lost his tether with Mania. It lasted too long. And now Soshka. He's being slowly whittled away by this Weaver. But not going to work. Funzy jumps down. Flame breaks him back. And that's going to be enough time. Or is it? Shikuchi away. Two heroes lost there for Flipside, and in the counter you're talking about, the hard counter, that Naga Oldman, absolutely perfect for Mad.
Yeah, that was just a beautifully well-executed team fight. They threw down the Naga Siren ultimate, and they still were able to land the first call-down hit. Bucking Mad had perfect timing there, dropping the ultimate just in time for that first hit to land, and from there, that was just the end of the team fight. Unfortunately, Wisp trying to get out, he was able to get out. If he'd been able to save CK, that would have been a decent fight, but still... Quantic, they were able to pick off two really important heroes, both of the most important cores on Flipside, and on top of that, take that Roshan with the advantage they just gained.
Ping came out, but it was too late. Ryze was like, hey, they're going Roshan, and then like 2 seconds later, Roshan goes down. 12 to 10 now on the board. And this advantage, jumping up and down. I said there wasn't much in it last time, but now they're definitely like, we're definitely going over some Rocky Mountains. Starting off with about 1,500 experience advantage for Quantic. Then it went to Flipside by about 6.5. And now it's coming back down again, sitting at about 3.5 in favor of Flipside. Even the gold was 2k to Quantic. Then 5k to Flipside. And it's coming back down again, sitting at 3.5k now. Just the changing of this game. Nice blink timing from Funzy. Second he saw Unicorn come out of Invis, he jumped away.
Flipside's doing a really good job getting aggressive vision up on the map for the Wisp CK ganks. One thing they're really missing, though, is that Ancient, where Silent is actually popping a stack. That would have been a really big opportunity for them to pick off an easy hero who separated into himself, because the rest of the team isn't going to sit on him while he does an Ancient stack. Mm-hmm. So they unfortunately missed out on the opportunity, and that really would have been a big one, because now he picks up his BKB off of that, and now they have some really solid team fight. If the rest of their ultimates are up, Bucky Mad, he just hit level 11, so you can rely on that cooldown a little bit more, only a 2-minute cooldown now. As soon as that's up in 30 seconds, I think they're going to go ahead and try and force a fight here.
Well, I'll see if you're right, man. We will definitely see if you're right. Miguel still caught out in the top lane. He can TP in, but not to a tier 1 tower to join his teammates very, very quickly. First thing I would say, you want to fight a 5v5, you're going to do it with 5. So they have 3 people there in the middle lane. Even now, CK Wisp going to separate themselves out. Just checking out that 22-minute rune. Not going to be there. In fact, already taken before. The illusion rune for the Puck. And TP top lane. Fucking Mad. The first time I see that, I instantly think CK and Wisp, are they thinking about getting a kill from that? Soshka's fighting up against a fake version of himself. Funzy's in the neighborhood, Rift in. Follow-up stun, Tether as well. 2 seconds only on that stun on Funzy. Sorry, going to keep him alive. And Stick Charges. Wow. Gets him up on the hill. With the tombstone drop, they don't want to be part of that one. Funzy now managed to get the last two of Mania. Darkseer Walls to get a copy of Mania. He pops up the BKB. Rift up. He wants Funzy. 4 seconds on the stun. Can they kill him off in time? No, they can't. But what they do is kill him. And they get a little extra gold for that one. Put CK on the sidelines. And now Wisp. Whoop. That's not the place you want to ulti into. He's able to tether himself away to Miguel. While Unicorn through the tier 2 tower in the bottom lane is approaching the tier 3.
Yeah, he's constantly keeping up pressure. You notice I was calling it Miracle. He knows the right thing to do. He goes ahead and throws down an aggressive ward in the ancient area. So now Gyrocopter can no longer farm that. But he does have his BKB plus Aegis, so it's already too late to kind of even attempt to gank him. As well as that very aggressive laning ward that he just circled.
Mm-hmm.
So, really well done.
Keeping it deep, keeping the vision good. And that keeps the options open for where Ryze wants to move. Obviously, there's no way. It's like two different setup wards, too, you got to have. One ward to know that the person's by themselves, and the secondary ward to know that there is no backup that could make them not by themselves. There was a lot more, more profound way to say that, but at the end of the day, it became a lot more simple than I thought.
It's okay, Toby.
Thanks, man.
Your viewers come here for the excitement and the energy you bring to the cast, not for the profound sayings.
Damn it! I thought it was always about profound sayings. Oh, Funzy. Big courier to snipe out. That's a Lincoln Sphere if he can get it. This is worth a blink to actually take it out. Yeah, the pings are coming, but Unicorn now. Courier. Well, Funzy will stay with it. This courier won't survive this. But it delivered its goods. It delivered its Lincoln Sphere over to Unicorn. I'm guessing Funzy just lost vision of it then, but he should have seen it.
That was good on Funzy. Not trying to go for the Weaver. I'm presuming he had already clicked on the courier and saw it was carrying.
Mm-hmm.
But that would have been hilarious if right as he picked up Lincoln's, Funzy tried to ultimate. Lincoln's immediately successful. But instead he just picks out the courier. Well done. They're actually going to go ahead and see if they can trade a tier 2 for a tier 1 at bottom. Which is the really smart play here. On top of that, they're also going to be pressuring the tier 2 at top soon.
Quantic coming back. Fucking Mad Plus start in the middle lane. Ganking that up is next
which
to
is
impossible.
An opportunity.
Oh, where's Whis? Yeah, you're right. Gold black, but Funzy. He's in here. Lasso wants to pull Mania further away, and there goes Soshka putting down the wall, but they've got to get rid of this damn Wisp before he's old. He pulls him back out again, and it won't work. This Phantasm, there's so many illusion images up right now, combining it with the wall. 2 seconds on the stun over on Soshka, won't get himself away. One last crit from the CK doing his job. Now Puck throws the ulti down. Mania back in here with Funzy. Going to keep walking through this wall, but doesn't bother him at all if he can manage to keep getting these kills, but he's going to lose his own life for this. Wisp ball back into this game. Unicorn trying to help out his teammates. Miguel, the ensnare, wonderfully done. Managed to hold him just long enough.
You know, that was an opportunity, right? Once you see those teleports come back, you're like, all right, who's left in that lane for me to be able to pick off? So they saw that opportunity. The Quantic, they did a good job defending that. They stayed grouped up. Batrider was sitting down there waiting for a teleport like that. And that was all well done. I just feel that a faster BKB by Chaos Knight would have wrecked that team fight and cleared off some of those easy kills much faster. And the less damage would have gone down all around. But still, that was a 2-for-2 trade. Not terrible for Flipside in any ways. It's unfortunate they lost the puck, but the big thing is Weaver is going to get very big very, very soon. He's about to pick up his next big damage item.
That's great for Weaver, but Gyro's getting really big too, man. He's got 3,400 gold up on that Gyro, and beyond that, he's got the support of a Darkseer as a mech and pipe. Not to mention the wall, which is already causing issues, as you saw during the last fight. Unicorn's damage isn't high enough yet. And to have the ability to live. Because between having the Naga ult to go off, and then you're going to have Gyro with his damage, which is starting to rack up a little bit more. You've got all these different things you got to calculate in. Unicorn just doesn't have enough damage and survivability to add all into the one. The biggest problem he will have is if Darkseer continues to farm up and actually affords up his scythe device, which will be his next item. If that comes up, Weaver is boned.
Yeah. I'm wondering what Gyrocopter's next item is going to be, because he can't go. He has to know he can't go Butterfly due to the fact that MKB is going to be picked up on Weaver soon. It would still be strong. Honestly, it would still actually be really strong versus the Chaos Knight, because obviously he's not going to be able to have his MKB, and that Phantasm physical damage is really, really big. So he may still go it, but instead it looks like he's just going to go for MKB. Mm-hmm. Max out his damage.
Yeah. Find those stuns, get rid of the illusions. That's what it's all about, man. That's what it's all about. And now four man Dota down the mid. Meanwhile, top lane, Miguel, there's actually help coming into Soshka. But yes, 3 seconds on the stun. They're on the run out. Wispol has already been used for this one, and have actually brought about two TPs and two normal rotations. Bungie's got Blink 4 stuff off cooldown, but he's not going to catch up to Miguel. Miguel stopped moving for a little second. Not going to happen.
That was, like, a failed gank, sure, but that it had all the right things there, where if they forced teleports, they got out of a potential bad team fight. And Unicorn, again, continuing to just push down this bottom lane. He had an opportunity there to do some good damage to the tier 3, but he had no idea where the rest of Quantic was. Didn't know that they were all still top.
Mm-hmm. Silent, speaking of top, there goes your team. Oh, wow. What, really? Miguel got the denial on that top tower.
Behold.
That's
what a play.
That's gonna be Silent spitting a little bit of chips there. Shouldn't be happy, man. Shouldn't be happy at all. Soshka,
he's gonna have sheep soon.
Batrider?
Miguel.
I was about to say, like, wait, what? Quantic has a sheep stick? No one near that last time I checked. But yeah, you're right. You're right. He's only sitting about 600 or so gold away from having a full scythe of ice. Add that one to the mix. There's no real BKBs that are going to work for you, but at the same time, depending when he gets that Scythe device off, if he doesn't control off the Naga, and Naga gets that ultimate off, the Scythe device will be all for nothing. Even if there are BKBs about to pop up, you've still only got one of those. So CK can move freely, but then again, Fun's got this wonderful thing called a lasso as well. Can't BKB break out of that, you little sucker.
No.
And Silent's about to get... Is Silent going to have it? Nah, not with this creep. With the creep wave, if he gets another creep wave from the bottom lane, he'll now have his Monkey King bar. Short by 70.
Yeah. Weaver just picked up a Demon Edge, which is good. They would like to have MKB for this next Roshan fight, but hopefully Demon Edge is going to be enough for them. They have the Wisp CK teleport in. Problem is, again, just these grouped up team fights are very, very easy for Quantic just... To win. Mm-hmm. They need to split push much, much harder, and it looks like they're going to try and focus on taking this tier 2.
Well, they'll be successful with the tier 2 tower. But, in we go for Roshan. Roshan already down almost half of his life in the space of what was about 10 seconds. So it shouldn't take much longer. And Miguel plus Miracle, they know what's going on. But they want to add pressure to the tier 3 tower. Funzy with his Firefly, just making sure that no one else is here. And now the TPs are going out. They want to hold their top tower with CK as she came in here with the ultimate. And now Naga throws out his own ultimate. Wisp is going to have to leave CK behind. Or will he? No, the tether was still up there. But that actually makes it a lot easier for Quantic to fight this one. Vac in a wall. Miguel and Miracle both held in position. Puck and Crystal Maiden go down. And they just took the Aegis Immortal as well.
The idea was right. They just needed to bring everybody else away. Just have the CK Wisp be the ones targeting down that tower with the Phantasm. They're going to keep pressure. Like, even though the Aegis is there and you, Quantic, have this big advantage, there's still an incredible amount of split push to deal with. So as long as they don't die like that, as long as they force the movements with those CK Wisp ganks and take towers or get an Ice Hero kill, even if they don't take the tower, they don't take the hero, they're still going to put Quantic on the defensive where they can't stay grouped up. They're constantly having to move around, which leaves Weaver the ability to just keep on split push and keep up that farm and potentially bank opportunities for little pickoffs.
Mm-hmm. Monkey King Barn now fully done up for Silent. Let's get this party started, man. Let's get this party started. Get the heart up on Naga, Diffuser Blade, Yasha already done. Soshka wants the Aghanim tipped it up. It's all about going in. The Monkey King Bart is flying out now. A Mania and CK. Where are they supposed to gank now, man? Like, there's no warding for him. There's one aggressive ward left for him on the map. One.
Yeah. They have to use it defensively from here on out. They have to push aggressively, split push, try and force Quantic to come to them, and then just sacrifice Wisp. just use the relocate purely to defend the Chaos Knight. Maybe if they see an opportunity, go for a tier 3 with the Phantasm. But other than that, it's just going to be purely defensive split push, maybe teleporting to a team fight.
Funzie's looking for somebody who's ballsy enough from Flipside to challenge him. Fire flying in as close as he possibly can. And he'll see Unicorn just on the edge of his screen for a moment. But his Firefly is wearing off. Bottom tier 3 tower has now come under siege. But at the same time, Quantic are committing him. The Tombstone is down, and they want to try and force us here in mid. Solrev, to keep people alive, look to pop that ult, and still we got CK Wiz. They just took out that tier 3 tower in the bottom lane. And Quantic, they're just going to go for the trade. But CK Wiz also will do the same thing. Milliracks. Now they can come back. Has it been Milliracks yet? There she goes. Range racks as well, and the tower. They ulted themselves up to the tier 3 tower in the top lane. I don't know if they can actually go for a full double raxing right now. There's TP support coming back. Wisp, oh! He left Mania behind! He lost the tether, and now Mania is locked up here. He has to pop off his BKB in a moment. 4 seconds on the stun on Soshka. There's going to be more TPs down. 3 napalm stacks. There's it back, pull him back. 4 napalm stacks. Flamebreak flies up, gonna miss, but it's still gonna be the death of the CK. And now I'm down middle lane. Silent on the run from Gyro. Agency model will pop. We've got Tombstone to drop. Middle of the fight too. Miracle is obviously the first target here of Bucking Mad, able to be successful on that one. Silent with a mega kill streak, in fact. It was Gyro with his flat cannon that did the damage. And now he wants to add a little bit more pressure down that middle lane, but they've got tier 2 towers to take down. And that's where the line's been drawn. Top lane is actually in fact where the line's being drawn. That one's coming off from Soshka.
That initial play by Flipside was actually really, really smart. The only bad thing was Wisp was unable to get that tether off to bring CK back. If they'd been able to force the teleports away, taken a tier 3 and a Rax in exchange for their own tier 3 and a Rax, like they came out on top, even with that gank. And they're going to go top here.
Give her a shot, man. They've already found Soshka, but in comes Funzie. Lasso up on Miguel. Dragon back. Flame break. It's a lot of damage. Soshka will still go down this one, but Wisp. Ulti will take him out in 1 second. And he takes Unicorn with him. So it becomes a 1-1 trade, but Darkseer very quickly buys back into the game. Rather surprising considering how much money that would have cost and how close he was already to having his Aghanim Scepter. But he wants to stay up and alive. Puts his buyback on cooldown for 6 minutes. Oh, he's going to need that buyback too. With a Vladimir's offering up on a Wisp and a Heart on a CK, there is so much life coming the way of Flipside during this later portion of the game.
Yeah, it's going to be very, very tough. Unicorn, you can either go for another damage item, probably not going to be going Butterfly because MKB on Silent. So he can either go for another damage item for a Heart of his own. He can go something like a Manta, which is going to really help out his split push and really keep Quantic on their toes constantly.
Mm-hmm.
Or he can go for, you
TP's
know, Heart or...
Oh, Funzie! That was the wrong place to actually Firefly yourself, force dive yourself into, and now he gets destroyed! The Phantasm and the 4 second stun. Miracle goes down the flat cannon, and that is a big lot of damage coming off with not only the images coming off from the Naga, but that slow, the hole, the ulti! It's buying the time. Now it's going to turn off. They want Unicorn. He's too far away. Come back and back in again. Miguel now comes in. Puckoldy available. But he's just trying to make smoke a distraction. Pull back in again. Where's the Gem? Not there. But they're out of invis now. And Silent turn into a chicken. That Soul Rip keeps him alive. In fact, that extra damage helped him out. Now the Darkseer Wall goes down. Only one hero left alive right now. But Flipside, it's going to be Unicorn and Quantic. Another decay. Just keeps sucking his life away from him. The buyback will this time come from the puck. And all they lost in that was a gyro? There had to be other buybacks. We had buybacks by the puck, had buybacks by the Batrider. Okay, that's what it was. And a buyback by the Darkseer, which was before. So two buybacks, one from either side during that last fight.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, smart buyback by the Batrider. Since he got blown up so early in that team fight, he recognized it was going to be a long one. He could come back in and still be really effective. Bucking Mad is actually getting very dangerous as a sort of semi-carry. Like, Gyrocopter is obviously still going to have a lot more gold, and he's going to be the one, but You look at Bucking Matt, he's working his way. He has his Manta. Once he has his heart, you're actually looking at a very traditional Naga Siren carry. And that's going to become dangerous. I think Flipside, they have to end this game soon. Like, they were good on time for a while just because it was just a gyrocopter carry, but now that Naga Siren's being able to get more and more farm, they can't just rely on Weaver CK. Neither one of them are a harder carry than this Naga Siren's going to be, especially with a gyrocopter mixed in.
Say hello to Miguel. Funzie with his Firefly vision, just playing with him. Blinks up and away. And no, Miguel wants to play. CK bringing in the ulti, but Soshka's already here. He doesn't have his wall available, and Funzie 2 seconds only on the stun, but it's still more than enough time. Gem's going to be on the deck. Tombstone takes a fall. Nice decay. However, Unicorn being backed in. Pull him back in again. Oh, what a time for the ulti to wear off. Go, Scepter. Unicorn needs to Chikuchi him. That's why the decay goes. Miguel blinks his way in, but now he's in too deep. Silent with that Rocket Barrage. Miguel jumps down, but the flat cannon follows him. And they get the gem back again. No one's quite sure who. Okay, so it's going to be Soshka. Gives up his TP. He gives the gem back over to Naga, just in case. But 2 for 2 is a trade. One core, one support. That's fine.
It's hard making those decisions, but I almost wonder if that would have been a better fight if Ryze had left Mania there.
Hmm.
It could have gone terribly wrong, but it also could have allowed them to be able to clean up a lot more hills.
Oh, Naga ulti. It caught out too. Soshka, he can't use his Sol Ring. He's short of mana. He can't throw off his wall just yet, but it might be enough time. Unicorn, time lapse is out. A lot of this damage, the tether from Ryze, keeping Unicorn up, and also a lot more powerful. Soshka, he will finally go down, but Mania, 134 life points. Silent stands his ground, and Mania, one more hit. Silent kills him up before the Rift can complete. Fucking mad on a mega kill streak now. Four heroes on the sideline for Flipside, and this really does look like Quantic. They control this game, but they still have tier 2 towers to get through. They need to get rid of these tier 2s, and they need to quell this bottom lane. That tier 4 tower is almost down. Tombstone and Silent Force to return to defend it. And I'm wondering if Silent just goes all in on this one. He's got 3800. He buys BTs. So now he's running double boots.
If Wisp had enough money for a buyback there, they could have turned that fight. They could have both bought back and teleported back in with the Wisp ultimate. It would have been pretty crazy, but they would have been able to kill Silent and the rest of them should have fallen from there. But unfortunately, they were missing it just by 300 gold. And now they're going to start losing their tier 2s. Undying's going to be able to push back this bottom lane as much as possible. They're going to try and regain some map control, which is going to free up Naga Siren to be able to farm up even more. She almost has that heart. She's going to be able to pick it up right now.
Perfect timing too. Roshan spawns 15 seconds from now. And this is going to be a rough time. Mask of Madness comes out for Funzie. We saw this the other day. It's amazing, the movement speed you get in a Batrider. You may as well have a haste rune.
Yeah.
Whoever he grabs is going to be dragged so far away that even Wisp won't be able to tether to them. And that, I believe, is the plan right now. Rosh is up. And also, Flipside. All their players up and running, apart from Weaver, who for some reason decided to run out through that top lane. The same time as Roshan spawns up in Funzie, you can see him looking for a kill. He wants blood, throws down a first observer ward. We'll see CK in the middle lane, and also Wisp right behind him. Doesn't want to take the risk, especially when he's already aggroed one of these little creeps in. But there's TP's now coming. Tier 2 tower, Silent comes in. Remember, there's still the Super Size Me creeps on that middle lane, but oh, this is what they're going to do. In through top, Flipside. They know that Quantic is going to go for Roshan. They want to do a counter Rax. That's the plan. This is an Aegis and a cheese, however, for a Roshan, which is more than enough the Quantic would need to win this fight. TP's already coming back. Bucking Matt, if he needs to use his ultimate to stop them, he will do so, and it's going to work. Flipside are too slow getting in.
It's too late. If they'd had the opportunity to just go straight into the Rax with the Phantasm, they would have just blown it apart. Unfortunately, Naga Siren is just too good versus this strategy. And they're going to have a very hard time taking Rax in a sneaky way like that.
You see what Bucking Matt is doing? He's not going into the heart. He's bypassing the heart and just leaving a vitality booster on him.
Okay, I'm good with that.
Straight into butterfly. Also, choice of cheese. Undying is the carrier for the cheese. But I would watch during the team fights to see if he just hands it over and doesn't use it himself. If there is someone, if Gyro goes down, he will hand that cheese directly back over. Hearing an ulti on bottom lane at Sant, just TPing himself out. They got nothing that can go through his BKB to stun him. Wisp ulti now down. Split push potential is a lot more dangerous for Flipside now. And in fact, it might be a hell of a lot more dangerous. They came back in the middle of the Quantic side. If only Quantic knew they're a little bit higher up. Firefly is going.
Oh god.
They're gonna find the Wisp. Ryze is dead. There is no survival from this one. Where's the ensnare? Hold him there. Ensnare, ensnare, ensnare. Not being used. They just kill him up the old-fashioned way. And CK is on the wrong side of this map. But at the same time, Unicorn has given enough momentum to the bottom portion of this map that someone has to come back. And it's going to be Silent. Uses the rocket to trigger the Lincoln Sphere. And leaves the rest of his teammates to do what they have to do on the top lane. He'll TP in 11 seconds when his BTs are off cooldown.
They're going to go for Rax. They're pinging it right now. They're going to go and try and backdoor this Rax. Unicorn's going to keep the backdoor protection off by staying inside the base.
Manny can
He's
do
staying
this.
Inside the base to make sure this happens.
Phantasm will be enough. There's already a TP coming back. And who is it? There is already Mania and Silent. They're going to push him back. And maybe it will be enough. Halasu, and there goes Mania. The attempt is blowing. At the same time though, now the BTs are coming. This is Gyro coming back into the fight. And Unicorn, the Darkseer wall goes up, tries to back him back in, but he only got one copy, but that still will be enough. Miracle dies right in the middle of it all. Flat Cannon will follow through. The Tombstone does take a fall as well, but with the Flat Cannon, the creep wave's dying very, very quickly. Miguel forced to blink himself away. The middle lane's already pushed in, so they can finish up this top racks. There's no backdoor regen. CM will buy back. The defenders of Quantic are now making their way back up the middle lane. Oh, that Rift.
Oh, no.
That would have been a huge hit if it managed to latch, and now it doesn't. Rift goes on Soshka. He might live through this one. Flamebreak gonna bounce him around. No, it won't. Naga says no fun. Naga says no fun. And where is this Darkseer? There'll be a fact. Pulls him in. And then Funzy tried to go for the lasso. It held him out. But CK, he pulls both the... He has the Wisp who pulled the CK out. Unicorn's on the run, but the blink into a Flamebreak gets the kill. Now buyback by the Weaver, they've got all this top racks at all costs. Silent Frost bitten up. Miguel low on life. He should be able to get himself away from this one, and he will be able to. Tombstone on the sidelines. Meanwhile, back in the main fight, Mania trying to fight this one off. Soshka, very low on life. Tethered through, Spirits as well. Mania falling back, he's being healed up. Bucky Mad trying to slow him down, will be successful. The side device popping up again. Mad can't get himself any kind of big space. Buyback came out from the Wisp. Couldn't hold Unicorn in position. Not with the ensnare. Now there's one Rax, fucking Mad. Unicorn, he had just enough damage to kill him off, but he couldn't do it once. There was too many of them. Now the Aegis Immortal will finally trigger off for the gyrocopter. Weaver on the sidelines, up being lassoed in. Mania, he wants Goldblack, but he can't do it. Not while the Ghost Hunter is up, and not while Goldblack has over 2k life points. He just keeps decaying, but he's going to eat through it. Mania, with a 2 second stun, gets it. Now to Funzy, pulls him in. What a blink! Jumps out of the reality rift and Silent's right behind him. The rockets on Mania. Mad trying to get there in close range so he can get himself an ensnare off. Not gonna happen. Rocket will hit. Now the ensnare can go. Not required. Funzy on a killing spree. Only one person left up. Puck is there, but man, you can call the GG, but you can also get props to Flipside for their defense.
That was, oh my goodness, what a long team fight. They had some really amazing plays back and forth, some really key buybacks. Flipside, they held on to their gold because they knew this team fight was going to be very, very tough. Unfortunately, with the Aegis advantage of Silent, they just couldn't finish it off. And he was just able to put way too much damage in the team fight. Multiple flat cannons every single time. I think it all just comes back to, you know, Flipside, they had a really good strategy and they were doing well controlling Quantic. It was just they made a couple of little mistakes that just worked against them. They just weren't able to take that second Rax, especially their backdoor attempt at top really cost them heavily. So all around extremely well done by both teams, but Quantic proved to be the tougher team. Still though, Flipside, I didn't think they were going to be as much as strong as a team going up against Quantic, especially with the way Quantic has really been dominating a lot of teams. Their recent performance in DreamHack was very, very strong. All around, I thought that Quantic was going to decimate Flipside, but they proved me wrong with a really tough three games.
Oh man, Quantic, this was not the easiest trek for them at all, but Their path has made it all the way to the LAN finals now. They took the number one position in the group stage, which means they will be in Poland. Quantic, I look forward to seeing all you boys there. Of course, most of them are actually returning. Gallblack not attending the last one, but these guys will be there this time around. And that makes it so that Flipsid, they'll have to actually go through the lower bracket. And that'll be happening next week, but tune in tomorrow. You'll check out the details. All the schedules be available over on joinDOTA.com or at RaidCall-EMS.com. Easiest places to find all the information as far as the RaidCall League goes. Capitalist Man, thank you very much for joining me today. It's been an absolute pleasure. Pimpage, all that kind of shizzle.
Yep, twitch.tv/DOTA Capitalist. I am turning on the stream right now, so please... please come check that out. If you just want to come over and check it out for a few minutes because you're tired of watching Dota and that sort of thing, I completely understand. But please come follow that channel. It would really mean a lot to me if you guys did that. Also, you can check me out at twitter.com/DotaCapitalist as well. And that is it for my pimpage, Toby.
Beautiful. TobiWan Dota for all of mine. Thanks for watching, peoples. We will see you all tomorrow. 18 CEST. Set those alarm clocks. Make sure you wake up and we'll see you then.